sea and the trouble with nature. Chapter 11. The trouble with secret nature and adults' actual tricks is everyone wanted to see it straight away, which I suppose was a good job, really, because we only had about 3 minutes before our morning lesson started. Gather round quickly, everyone, I said, unzipping the zip on my school bag. Not too close, I said as I took my empty mini chatter's packet out of my bag. Everyone was so excited to see my secret nature, they completely forgot about not getting too close. Get ready to be amazed, I said, tipping out my mini chatter's packet and rolling my secret nature onto the palm of my actual hand. Yes, I know, my actual hand. I actually had some actual secret nature in my actual hand. I'll tell you about that later. It looks like a gray pea, said Porter. Uncle, I said, waving my fingers like a wizard and then holding up my secret nature for everyone to see. It's uncloning, gasped Gabby. It's turning into a gray pea with legs. She was right. Instead of being curled up like a ball, my secret nature was now beginning to open up and wiggle. 14 legs, I grinned. I've counted them. The moment everyone realized that my secret nature had 14 secret legs, they came even closer. Hey, presto! Call me into a ball again, I said, tapping my secret nature on the back with my finger. It's curling up into a ball again, gasped Gabby. Now it looks like a gray pea without legs. I told you it could do tricks, I smiled. They're not tricks, said Barry, squeezing through to the front for the closest look out of anyone. It's a defense mechanism. And it's not a gray pea with legs either, said Jack. It's a woodlouse. Jack's right, Daisy, said Barry. It's a common woodlouse. As soon as everyone heard that brought an actual woodlouse to school, they moved in even closer. If it's so common, how come no one else has brought one? I said, realizing that Barry and Jack were a little bit jealous. I thought everyone was going to bring woodlice in, said Jack, so I didn't even bother. Does it do anything else? Asked Gabby, not really caring whether it was a trick or a defense mechanism. Watch this. I tilted the palm of my hand like a slide and pointed my fingers at the mud. Hey, presto! Whoa! The moment I tilted my hand, my secret nature did exactly as I had commanded. Rolling! Just like a ball. All the way across my palm, down my fingers and straight onto the mud. Do all woodlouses do tricks? Asked Gabby, giving my secret nature the loudest crap she could without the teachers being able to hear. All woodlice have defense mechanisms, if that's what you mean, said Barry. Their articulated body armor allows them to curl up into a ball the instant they feel threatened. I wasn't threatening him, I frowned. I was giving him magic commands. Rolling up into a ball is still a defense mechanism, not magic, said Jack. Well, it looks like magic to me, said Gabby. And me, I said as the bell rang. And me, 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 said just about everybody who'd never seen a woodlouse before either. There was absolutely no doubt about it. Of all the secret nature people had brought in, mine was totally the best. As soon as morning lessons are over, let's come back and see how our nature has settled in, said Gabby as we headed into class for a morning register. Good idea, I nodded, dropping my mini chatter's packet into a bin along the way. And if Mrs. Peters asks us to do any work at all during morning lessons, let's tell her we're not doing any school stuff today. We're just going to think up new tricks for my windows. Maybe not such a good idea, chuckled Gabby.